A Waggy!
A Bowie!
I'm the Queen!
Good morning, everybody.
Okay, guys, I'm having a bit of a hard time because pregnancy. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm all I talk about, but get used to it. I'm having a rough time right now. I hate when people say, you know, you're not actually eating for two, or in my case, for three. You can say that all you want, and doctors can say that all they want. Maybe that's true. But explain to me why, when I am pregnant, I am starving to the point of, like, I'm literally, like, I'm not joking around. Like, this is not me trying. Like, I am jittery, shaky if I'm not eating kind of always. So today I've already, it's only like noon, and I've already eaten a bagel. I've had Pop-Tarts. I've had grapes. I've had a bunch of water. And I'm literally, like, I was just editing and had to stop because I was shaking so bad. I felt like I was gonna faint because I know I'm hungry. Before I was pregnant, I could eat like nothing all morning and then for lunch, like just eat Pop-Tarts. I don't think that's healthy, but I wouldn't be hungry. I wouldn't be shaky. I'd just be like, oh, let me just put something in my stomach so that I can keep functioning. But I like wouldn't even think about food. And now it's like, even if I'm not hungry, which I don't feel hungry right now, I just can tell my body's like,
but food and no.
And this is what happened with Flynn. With Flynn, I gained 70 pounds. I hate that they put like restrictions on you. I think every pregnancy is different. Every woman is different. They say you're only supposed to gain like 30 pounds or something like that. I don't know. I'm not a scientist. Please don't take my word for any of this. But that was like looked down on, that I had gained 70 pounds. So it was like too much to gain, apparently. But like it wasn't. It was what I needed to gain to grow Flynn. And I don't feel guilty about it. And these babies are freaking hungry. They're hungry all the time. They make me eat constant. I'm constantly eating. I'm still always like shaky because I'm starving. Oh, these carrots are bad. No! I really wanted carrots with ranch. I need to find not rotten carrots. I'll be back later. Hello, beautiful people. I'm about to do cast party, pajama cast party, which is talked about a million times, but in case you haven't heard or don't remember, cast party is a show, an open mic night that happens in New York City. It is the first place I ever performed live as Miranda Sings, like 12 years ago, 11 years ago. And one of my dear, dear, dear friends runs the show. His name is Jim Crusoe. He's amazing. And since the pandemic, he started doing it virtually and I've gotten to do it a couple times. So I'm doing it tonight. That's what I'm doing right now. I hope I'm on mute because otherwise it's awkward. I just finished doing cast party and let me tell you guys, I feel very sick, but I love Jim Crusoe so much and it was so fun to just chat with him and hang out with him. He was like, do you just want to come on and chat with me on the show? And I was like, yes. That's what we did. You can go watch it. We have a YouTube channel if you would like to watch it. Right now I miss Flynn because I haven't seen him in like an hour because I was doing the show, so I'm gonna go see him right now. I'm very excited. The heck? What's in there? What could it be? What is it? What is it? Don't open it.
Unless you pickle it.
Magnifying glass.
Whoa!
Gotta get everything out of it.
What is that?
I'm a little teapot!
Whoa. What is a teapot?
A little teapot?
Whoa!
Flynn, what do you think? You put water in there and pour it in the cups?
Yeah. Put water in here and put the water.
Well, what are you gonna pickle from the box?
This.
Oh, that's what you pickle? Okay, you gotta put everything back.
I'm a little teapot. And steps. Here's my hands. Here's
the goat. Wait, where's the magnifying glass? Delicious.
Oh, hey, I'm thirsty. Can I have some tea, please? Oh, thank you. Let me try it. Mmm, that's delicious.
Are you gonna try it?
Juice.
Juice, yummy juice. Is it good?
I'll try the yolk.
Okay. Cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm, delicious. Mm. Wow, let's try the green one. Can you give me the green? Milk!
Yeah. Oh, let me try. Mine was chocolate milk.
Chocolate milk.
Coffee.
No.
Oh, it was milk.
I'll try some eggs.
I'll try some
eggs.
You got some egg?
Can
egg
I have
tea?
Some? What is
I
it?
Got some eggs.
Oh, this is eggs?
Yeah. Yummy, tea eggs.
Eggs. Oh, yummy eggs. Do you think Grandma wants some?
Yummy some eggs?
Grandma, which
you
color,
need some eggs?
Which color does Grandma want?
Yellow.
Grandma wants yellow. Do you want to give her some tea?
Yummy.
Oh, thank you so much. Oh, it's iced tea! Oh, it's my favorite. Yeah. Oh, can I have some orange?
Thank you.
Mmm, it's chocolate ice cream.
Whoa.
It's chocolate ice cream.
What's in here?
Ice cream.
Oh. It smells like ice cream.
He goes, ice cream, I just said it.
Really?
We're watching Naked and Afraid and I'm craving puppy chow. So let's make some puppy chow. Puppy chow. There's a lot of powdered sugar. I did like a quarter of what it said to do. Okay, relax.
Hello, lay with me.
Ew, gross, why did I say that? Unsubscribe to me right now. I don't feel good, guys. Why did I choose an under angle too? Like, this is the worst. Why did I do this? I just didn't want to get up. I don't feel good, so this is what you get. I asked you guys on Twitter what you wanted me to talk about. So I'm gonna answer some questions. So if that interests you, stick around. If that's not interesting to you, you can peace out because the rest of this vlog is just me answering questions from you guys on Twitter. One question I got a lot was about naming the twins. A lot of people asked, this is from Jaden. Jaden said, are you looking for cute matching names to go with the twins, like same letters or rhyming, etc.? No. Maybe we will once we figure out what they are. Right now we have a list of girl names we like and boy names we like. It's not very long because we only like one night for like 20 minutes talked about it and then we haven't again. We don't want them to be matching like Ron and John, you know, like it's more like we want them to sound fine together, but not like rhyming or matching. Do you know what I mean? It wouldn't make sense if it was like Francesca and Tweed. Why were those the names that came? But like, those actually kind of go together well.
Maybe.
I feel like some names wouldn't go together well. So we want the names to like go together, okay, but like not rhyme or match. But I don't know, I could change my mind. But no, we haven't come up with anything, but we're not planning on like rhyming or matching the names. Jesse said, I know you've been having a lot of Jolly Ranchers lately, so which is your favorite flavor? I have been eating a lot of Jolly Ranchers. Sometimes it helps me with my gagging episodes. And right now I really like watermelon. It's pretty good, but it depends on my mood. Sometimes I get sick of the watermelon flavor and I go for like green apple or the blue raspberry is pretty good. I'm not a big fan of cherry. Next one. Nicole said, are you planning to have a C-section? I'm not planning on it, but like if that happens, that's amazing. I think C-sections are incredible. I'm so grateful that C-sections exist. I'm a C-section baby. My mom had all four of her kids C-section. C-sections have saved a lot of lives and sometimes women choose to have C-sections and I think that's incredible. Whatever way you want to have a baby is your decision and I'm supportive and applaud any version of that. I do want to try to have the twins through my hole. I also know that C-sections are very common with twins, and so I'm very open to that idea. I know that's a possibility, and I'm fine with that being a possibility. I'm not like gonna be sad if that's what ends up happening. I've mentioned before that like the idea of a C-section scares me, and it's not that like I think C-sections are bad. It's just I've never experienced one, so the fear of the unknown kind of freaks me out because I've only ever pushed a baby out. I've never had a baby cut out and surgically removed. I know that that's safe and fine and incredible and all versions of having babies is amazing. So I'm not like, oh my God, I hope I have it vaginally. I'm more like, I'm gonna try and hope that that happens. But like, if it doesn't, that's fine too. Like, that's awesome. I honestly thought Flynn was gonna be a C-section baby because my mom only had C-section babies. Flynn was really big. I'm tiny. I just assumed. So when they were like, it's time to push, I was like, push? You're not gonna cut him out? I'm not planning for him to be a C-section, but if he is, that's totally awesome. He. The two kids. There are two in there. We'll get to that. How do you feel about the transition from one kid to three? Terrified, but also excited, but mostly terrified, but also very excited. Gabriel, okay, this one I have to address. We talk about this in the podcast this week, but like I need to address it on the vlog because I get this question every day, all the time. Gabriel said, my dad and my friend's mom, who have been looking at ultrasounds for years, say it looks like triplets. But again, don't want to make any assumptions. So many people think I'm having triplets.
You guys.
I'm not having triplets. It is twins. There are two babies. I've seen them at my ultrasounds. We've looked at them and we have counted them and we've heard their heartbeats. There are two babies. There's two ultrasounds that you guys have seen. One, it kind of looks like there's like three dark spots. One of the dark spots is fluid. What kind of fluid? Doo-doo fluid. So I was very stressed because I thought I was having a miscarriage, and that was the time I found out about the twins, that ultrasound, and I was really overwhelmed and stressed and had crazy urea. So there was fluid, and that's what you see. The second time that people are thinking is another baby is from the ultrasound that's kind of all over the internet of the twins. And it's because you kind of see two dots inside one of, there's two, the two sacs. And in one of them, you kind of see like two white dots. And people think that's two separate babies. It's not two separate babies. It's one baby in one sac. And there's one baby in the other sac. It's just because when you're moving the ultrasound machine around in there, when they take a picture, it's hard to kind of get both twins in the same shot. And so sometimes it like distorts the photo, or like you see, like you probably saw like the bottom of the baby and the top of the baby, but the middle kind of disappeared, I think is what happened in that photo. I'm not having triplets, guys. People keep thinking I'm gonna like announce that I'm having triplets. If I was having triplets, we would know by now, because I've been in to the doctor multiple times, they've checked multiple times. It's two babies, two heartbeats, I'm not having triplets. Savannah said, what's your favorite pregnancy product so far with this pregnancy? So far, it's my pregnancy pillow. I can't sleep without it. Pregnancy pillows are these big long, Flynn calls it a worm pillow. It's a big long worm. I get really bad hip pain and pelvic pain if I lay ever, like right now there's a pillow in between my legs. I cannot lay with my knees touching, like it hurts so bad, like they have to be separated. So that helps. And then once my belly gets bigger, your belly lays on the pillow too. I just love my pregnancy pillow. It's so amazing. It was probably my favorite product the first time around too. What are their products? I don't know. The C-Sick bands stopped working for me. I used those in the beginning of my first trimester and I think they helped. They don't really do anything now. My lifesaver right now is Jolly Ranchers and cold watermelon. Cold watermelon slices. Like if you are pregnant in your first trimester, if you like watermelon, lifesaver, because it's hydrating you. There's a crunch to it. So it's like satisfying. I can stomach it. So I get a big watermelon and we cut it all up when I'm not feeling sick. Then we put it in a box, like a little like container in the fridge. And then whenever I'm feeling nauseous, I just eat a bunch of chunks of watermelon. And it is, my God, guys, it's life changing. Krista said, talk about the fact that it's Pride Month.
It's Pride Month. It's Pride Month. It's time to be proud of the LGBTQ plus community. If you're a part of the community, you are awesome. Shout it loud and proud. If you're not a part of the LGBTQ plus community, support them. Don't be a clown. Unless you like clowns, then be a clown. But clowns kind of scare me. So let's celebrate the LGBTQ plus people, because we want equality.
I hate myself. I'm so excited it's Pride Month. I love Pride Month. I just love the LGBTQ plus community. I love supporting them. I love helping them in any way that I can. Yeah, I think it's awesome that it's Pride Month. Oh, you know what? I do have something to say about this. I've seen a lot of people throwing shade at the ugly Pride clothes. Target, Walmart, different places that have like Pride, or Amazon, like different places that are putting out a Pride line of clothing. I understand that they're ugly. Most of them are pretty ugly, but it's hard when I grew up in a time where like that did not exist in stores. Like Corey and I were talking about this the other day. For us growing up, like there's not a chance you would find rainbow Pride flags on clothes anywhere. Growing up, that would get you hurt. Like you, there was like the fear of like, if you were out and proud, it was dangerous. And so the fact that they're trying to put out clothes to like celebrate is amazing. And it like just kind of makes me a little bit sad that like maybe some of the clothes are kind of ugly, and that's fine to kind of like mention that to your friends and stuff. But like for the internet to just like fully attack them when they're like literally trying to be like, look, we'll support you and we'll put out whole sections of this to like say we're proud and we support. I think that's so cool that they are trying. I've never seen that my whole life. I'm just glad to see representation at all, because I think we need more of it. Hopefully over time, the stuff gets cuter and it gets better. Yeah, I just wanted to throw that out there. Just think about like how back in my day that didn't exist, and like that would have made like someone like Corey, or you know, anyone my age who might have been in the closet, like feel emotional and like excited to go into a store and see that there are clothes that say you can be proud to be who you are. So even though some of them might not
be like your cup of tea or out, you know, kind of ugly or whatever. Just like keep that in mind. I'm not saying like be grateful for what you get. Like obviously we should hope for better clothes because a lot of them are not cute. But it just makes me sad that like no one's celebrating the fact that they exist. Like that they're doing whole pride sections now. Do you know what I'm saying? But anyway, I don't know. Thoughts? I'd love to know your thoughts. Okay, Kaylin said, when are you gonna do more Colleen's Corner videos? They could help you off the minivan. Speaking of the minivan, I keep meaning to give you guys a tour of the minivan and show you our new minivan, because yes, we bought a minivan. So maybe I'll do that tomorrow. I just keep forgetting to do it. But yeah, that was one of the first things that happened after we found out we were having twins. Eric just like freaked out and like went and bought a minivan. And so he picked it out. He like did all the work. I don't know anything about minivans. I don't know anything about cars really, but he got a really cool minivan. And so I've been wanting to do like a tour of the minivan and show it to you guys, because it is pretty neato. So, oh, and Colleen's Corner, I don't know. I'll probably be doing them a lot more because I'm like pregnant and literally can't do anything. So I'm out of, do you hear me? I'm literally out of breath from now. I'm laying here, I'm not doing anything. It's all that progesterone. A lot of questions about cravings, weirdest cravings, most recent craving. Most recent craving was the puppy chow, which I just made, and I'll be very happy to eat that tomorrow. I ate a little bit tonight. The weirdest was probably the egg pickle mayo sandwich. That was pretty random. And I also crave Jack in the Box french fries a lot, which is very random. I've never craved Jack in the Box french fries literally my entire life. Like ever. I've never said I want Jack in the Box. I would never choose Jack in the Box. But there's been a few days where I'm like, I need Jack in the Box french fries. And that's been kind of weird. But anyway, I'm gonna go because I, for some reason, cannot breathe all of a sudden. So I'm gonna go import my footage and do my stretches for my pelvic girdle pain and go to bed. Tomorrow I get to see the babies. And tomorrow I'm getting the blood test to find out the genders. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, you guys. Looks like this, we're gonna win the prize. Okay, I gotta go.
You can relax. Colleen and Eric have a podcast. The world is scary and we're locked in our home. But now we have big microphones. So you can relax, that's the name of our podcast.